Hello friends. In this lesson, I want to answer a question that I've been asked quite often over the past month, ever since it became known that the developers plan to discontinue support for the Supervised Home Assistant installation method at the beginning of 2026. I've made quite a few tutorials on this method, since it allows you to get a fully functional home assistant, with features no different from the official Home Assistant OS, along with a working operating system based on Linux Debian, which can also be used to handle many other tasks. In my opinion, this is an optimal option, for example, for single-board computers like the Raspberry Pi or for relatively low-powered Intel systems. However, the more complex installation process or the lack of Linux-related tasks in many cases made this method less popular. Many people prefer the simple path of directly installing Home Assistant OS or virtualizing it, which is more optimal for powerful platforms. By the way, I myself have also been using Home Assistant OS as a virtual machine on the Proxmox hypervisor for quite some time. Naturally, this news didn't go unnoticed, and I've often been asked how to correctly and safely switch to a supported installation type without losing any data. In this video, using a Raspberry Pi 4B as an example, I will walk you through the process step by step. Before we begin, as usual, I kindly ask you to like this video and leave a comment below, as this helps with promotion via YouTube's algorithm. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, now's the perfect time to do so. I still have a few Raspberry Pi 4B single board computers, which I previously used as both my working and testing platforms. At the moment, I'm using mini PCs based on Intel processors, but today's topic isn't about them. This is one of the test servers that, back in the day, appeared multiple times in my reviews and tutorials. I specifically powered it on to record this lesson. This is a Raspberry Pi 4B with an operating system based on Linux Debian and Supervised Home Assistant installed. Before starting, I updated all installed add-ons, the kernel, and the supervisor to the latest version. And here is the very message indicating that this installation method is deprecated. It's exactly this notice that triggered the main wave of questions, although I had warned about it much earlier. On my social media, you'll find links in the description below the video. To preserve all settings, add-ons, and integrations, we need to create a full backup. If you've set up automatic backups, for example using the Google Drive backup add-on, the lesson link is in the description. Just make sure you have access to the latest version and you can move on to the next stage, installing Home Assistant OS. If, for some reason, you haven't set this up yet, then you need to create a backup manually. Go to the Settings menu and find the section called System. Here, look for the section named Backups. If you haven't configured anything here before, it will look something like this. Click the Backup Setup button. The setup wizard starts. Continue. Next, a key for encrypting your backups will be generated and displayed. You can copy and save it or download it using the link provided right there. Next, go to the recommended settings menu. This will automatically start the process of creating a full backup of Home Assistant itself and of all installed add-ons. Wait until it's finished. The duration depends on the amount of data being saved. It can take quite a while, especially if you have a large database. Done. Now an automatically created full backup of your system is available here. On this server, its size was just over 130 megabytes. Go to this section and download the backup to a disk. We'll be using it very soon. It's an archive that you can open and inspect. In my case, besides Home Assistant itself, there are more than 10 different add-ons. Not all of them are active, since this is a test server, but they're included in the backup anyway, because they are installed on the system. Now we no longer need the old system. Go back to the Settings menu, System, click the Shutdown button in the top right corner, and from the Additional menu, select the option to shut down the system. Since I'm using a Raspberry Pi 4B, we'll use the official tool from the website to flash the new OS. The link to the website is in the video description. Download the image writing tool. Install it. Now you need to connect the Raspberry Pi 4B storage device to your working computer where this program is installed. I use an Argon 1 case with an SSD. It connects using a cable with two identical USB-A connectors. Launch the installed program. In the main menu, there are three options available: select device, select operating system, and select storage location. Start with selecting the device. Here you need to specify the type of your single board computer. In my case, Raspberry Pi 4B. Next, go to the operating system selection menu. There are quite a few here, including the original Debian-based ones, which we used previously for supervised installation, and specialized ones. Right now, we need a specialized one. Look for the section that includes systems for installing home automation and 3D printing environments. Here, look for the section labeled Home Assistant and Home Automation. Next, find Home Assistant. And here, finally, select Home Assistant OS. At the time of recording this video, the version of the system being installed was 15.2. Any updates, if necessary, will come through once the system is up and running. And the final step, selecting the storage location. By default, the option to exclude system disks is enabled, so I can't select my laptop's SSD here. Only the single board computer's disk is available. Next, the current image is downloaded from the internet and written to the disk. Then, the correctness of the written image is verified. If everything was done correctly, you will see this message at the end. Now you can disconnect the drive and reconnect it to the single board computer. Then connect the network cable and power cable. The first system boot takes a few minutes. Be patient. After some time, it will appear in the router's network map. Since the MAC address remained the same, the router assigned the previously used device name, but the IP address, in my case, changed because it was issued automatically. I'll edit it a bit later. The system has started and proceeded to the initial Home Assistant setup. We need to wait. If needed, you can change the language of the setup wizard to one more comfortable for you. After that, a selection window will open. You can either start configuring a new system or restore a backup from a file or the Home Assistant cloud. In my case, it's a file backup. Next, specify the location of the previously downloaded backup that we made from the supervised installation. Select what to restore. As I mentioned before, I had many different add-ons installed, not all of which were active since this is a test server. But everything was included in the backup, and I'm restoring everything. Click the button, Restore Backup. Depending on the size, the restore process may also take a considerable amount of time. In my case, about 10 minutes. But if your backup is larger, it may take longer. After the restore, the login dialog appears. The username and password are the same as those used on the supervised installation. Log in, and you'll see exactly the same system, no differences. The notification that appeared here is related to the absence of automatic backups. This is normal and will disappear later. Or you can create a new backup from the current system. All previously installed add-ons are restored correctly, with all settings and data. This is the HACS custom repository store. It was also included in the backup and successfully restored along with all installed integrations. Devices added to the integrations were also restored. Here's the system information and logs page. I've shown before in my tutorials how to add a link to this page to the sidebar. Now the version of the operating system is displayed here, Home Assistant OS 15.2. The supervisor and kernel versions are current since the backup was created after updating. But even if the current version is newer than the one in the backup, that's okay. Updates will apply automatically on the new system. In the settings menu, system, network, I disable the automatic IP assignment mode and manually set the same address that was previously used for this server. The only thing I had to add was a custom add-on to control the Argon 1 case fan. Previously, it was managed by a native service installed at the Debian level. Here, everything is done according to the instructions in the official repository. To make it work, you need to temporarily install another add-on, HassOS I2C Configurator, which performs the necessary setup for I2C operation. Afterward, it can be removed. The add-on will gain the ability to control the Argon fan, according to the configured settings. In my case, it turns on when the temperature reaches 60 degrees Celsius, increasing speed as the temperature crosses the next thresholds. It works correctly. As you can see, the process of switching to Home Assistant OS is straightforward and fairly quick. Backups made on the supervised installation are fully compatible and allow for a complete transfer of all settings, add-ons, and integrations. All processes, creating and restoring backups, installing Home Assistant OS, are highly automated and practically eliminate the risk of error. The only issue remains the functionality of services installed on Linux Debian. If you need to keep them, then it makes sense to consider buying a new platform for Home Assistant OS, for example, based on Intel N4000 or a more powerful mini PC, like one with an Intel N100, to install the Proxmox hypervisor and virtualize both Home Assistant OS and the required version of Linux. Links to tutorials on this topic can be found in the video description. That's all for now. I hope you found the video interesting and useful. I'd appreciate your likes. They help promote the video on YouTube. If you don't want to miss new videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I'll include links to all mentioned resources, as well as my Telegram channels, social media, and smart home discussion groups. Feel free to join. It'll be interesting. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Peace to all.